Well, we can be sure that the history of the labyrinth goes back some 4,000 years or more. The earliest examples we have at the moment are prehistoric rock carvings, both in Europe and also in India. There, labyrinths found their way into the world of the Greeks and into the Romans. You find them as mosaics, particularly in Roman villas and public buildings. They found their way then into the early Christian church through manuscripts, into the floors of churches and cathedrals, and certainly by the medieval period, they'd spread as far as Arctic Europe, down into North Africa, as far away as places like Java and Sumatra, and also here in America amongst the Native American people, particularly down in the Southwest.
I think it's important to really be conscious of how different communities approach life. People kind of wonder, now, do I approach this somberly? Do I approach this silently? How do I walk? And so you tell them to bring their best selves, their most natural selves to it. And if it's an unusual experience for them and people haven't done it before, it's fun, you know, to be on the labyrinth together and to act like you do in your regular neighborhood. I see you over there, you know, I see you're a little bit ahead of me, and that's great, I'm supporting you. And so I think it really does mirror, you know, the dynamic that happens in our communities, which is a wonderful thing.